Okay, I'm going after my Apostasia anemone. I purchased a syringe from Walgreens. And it is a BD Plastipak 3 milliliter syringe. And I'm going to load it up with half a milliliter of some Walgreens brand lemon juice concentrate. And I'm going to go after that sea anemone. So, I'm going to up with fennel. To really get it in the anemone. Of course, I flicked a coral there. So, looks like I got it in its body. I'm trying to distribute the full amount, because that's what I'm supposed to do. And hope for the best here. So, goodness knows what's going to happen. I did inject it. He seems to have curled up around it. Some sort of bubbles coming out. I don't know if we can see any better this way. I'm hoping to, personally. I don't know. I guess time will tell as to whether or not we've gotten this guy to perish fully or not. But he certainly doesn't look happy anymore. Hopefully the nearby corals are going to be okay. And with just a half a milliliter of lemon juice, I haven't too terribly damaged my tank chemistry. Late back in position. Fish seem to be none the worse. And I've got my syringe here for another day. I'll let that run for a bit. See, now he's looking pretty bad. Biggest concern is I've hurt some of those nearby corals, but they did seem to close up pretty quickly, which is encouraging. Bubble or two is coming out there. Hopefully none of what I see dispersing are spores that would cause that Apostasia to worsen in my tank, given that I only have one currently. They are known to reproduce pretty simply asexually, even from the tiniest of fragments. They can regrow an entire animal. So they have pretty powerful regenerative properties. But again, I'm hopeful that it's not going to be happening in this case. So we'll see. All right. Stay tuned. Part one is complete. We'll see what part two brings.